Oh, did you see Black Panther? It was dope. I don't know why you so hyped. It was just a comic book movie. Cause it's 2018 and we finally got a Hollywood blockbuster about a black king during Black History Month with a majority black cast. Not just light-skinned black people, but dark-skinned black people also, because, you know, Hollywood don't hire but so many of them. Where none of the characters were on drugs, abusive, locked up, in poverty, in gangs, in slavery, a street criminal. The men weren't dressed as women. None of the women were objectified. In fact, the black woman was the smartest. The black woman was the strongest. The black woman was the most gangsterous in Africa, and not the poverty-stricken Africa that they conditioned us only exists, but beautiful Africa, when nothing was based on European standards, and they had advanced technology in their beads. And it touched on real issues, such as how our people are oppressed all over the world and how Africa has the most valuable resources in the world. They didn't try to make the white savior the hero of the movie. The black villain was actually reasonably justified for wanting the crown. The black father was in his son's life. They still connected to us using slang that we use. Even the bad guy that was white was a Jakku character. No one was ashy, no one was nappy, and Wale beat his feet for a whole 2 seconds. So the DMV made it in the film. Where was all this enthusiasm for Birth of a Nation? How many more slave movies we gonna get, bruh? Birth of a Nation, Roots, 12 Years a Slave, Lincoln, Django Unchained, Abraham Lincoln, Vampire Slave. It's too much. Man, it's nothing more than a superhero movie. How is that gonna help the black community? And besides, it had too much black on black crime in it. Negro, the cast was all black. I didn't hear you complaining about all the white-on-white violence in Braveheart. This movie ain't gonna end racism.
Never said it will.
You act like Malcolm X directed it.
Damn sure didn't say that either.
This ain't even the first black superhero movie.
Okay, so what's your point?
This film don't do nothing for black people. White man just sat up and made $500 million off of black people's hard work. And I'm supposed to be happy? No.
Black people can't even celebrate something black without black people getting mad.
Make sure they learn it's something more than
yeah,
just a fake.
You right.
That's the reason
yeah,
why.
Yeah, movies suck. Yup.
Okay, what's going on, y'all? This is your boy, Brother Tammuz, Brother Damuzi. Whichever one you want to call me, it doesn't matter to me. I wanted to give my review, my take on the Black Panther movie, and of course everybody has seen it by the time I've uploaded this, but I'm gonna keep it simple. Of course you see the title, you know where I'm headed with this. If you're somebody who's a part of the conscious community, or if you're someone who studies ancient Egypt, ancient Kemetic philosophy, and things like that. If you don't understand the movie's esoteric meaning, this movie had nothing to do with the CIA agent. This movie had nothing to do with Black Panther's timidity. This movie had nothing to do with Martin Luther King and MLK. This movie had everything to do with the Samatawi. This movie had everything to do with the joining of Upper Kemet and Lower Kemet, or Upper Egypt and Lower Egypt. This movie had everything to do with overcoming the root chakra, our lower chakra, coming out of those chakras into our solar plexus chakra, and ultimately releasing through the crown chakra. This movie had everything to do with Heru versus Set. That's what this movie was about. Everyone who says that, you know, they love the Killmonger character because he was this and he was that, keep in mind Lupita Nyong'o's character had the exact same philosophy. It's only that she went one way about achieving it and Eric Killmonger went away about achieving it. I haven't read the Book of the Dead, but I've read the novel by Ra'unefer Ammon called Heru Resurrection. And the way that he writes Isis or Aset in this book or in this novel is no different than Lupita Nyong'o's character in the Black Panther movie. And also, I'm glad I said that, in the movie, like right after when Lupita, what's the sister's name, Letitia Wright, who plays Shuri, and Angela Bassett, they're with the CIA agent and they're looking for a Black Panther. And keep in mind that Black Panther in this movie, he takes his father's position. Okay? Just like Heru did. Took his father's position. He is surrounded by, or just like in the Asarian myth, he is searched for by his mother, wife, and sister. I got this from Bobby Hemmett, and I had to go and research it for myself or look for it for myself. And there it was, clear as day. And of course, we have white authors like D.M. Murdoch, or some people call her Chari S., who talks about this in Christ in Egypt. Many authors talk about how Isis or Aset wasn't just Osiris's or Osar's wife. She was his wife, his sister, and his mother. I know a lot of people don't really care too much about the Egyptian philosophy and this, that, and third, but what Ryan Coogler was doing here, what he was showing us, and also get the book Ma'at, 11 Laws of God by Ra'unefer Ammon. What Ryan Coogler was showing us here was, It was really simple, and a lot of people are just taking it all over the place. The esoteric meaning wasn't that esoterically hidden. It was in plain sight, but it was hidden for people who don't know the Asari myth. Getting to the point, what Ryan Coogler was doing in this movie was showing us how to overcome our inner battles. Okay, stop with the secrecy. Of course, if you know the comics, Black Panther is a big keeper of secrets. And what you saw in the movie, how he was upset with the ancestors for keeping secrets, you're going to eventually find out that Black Panther is not a hypocrite, but how he utilizes information. Okay, very intelligent brother in the comics, but this is what Ryan Coogler was trying to explain to us through his writing, and the other guy as well. I forget his name, but this is what those two writers were trying to portray through these characters on screen. They were trying to tell a story of how we battle our inner demons and how to overcome those inner demons through tradition, through ancestral worship, through family, through community, and just being true to ourselves. That is how we overcome set. Now, Michael B. Jordan did an excellent job portraying Eric Killmonger. I like how they changed the story up from the comics. But to me, this wasn't a Marvel movie. Michael B. Jordan didn't play Eric Killmonger, nor did Chadwick Boseman play T'Challa. Michael B. Jordan was set. T'Challa, Chadwick Boseman, was Heru. In the comic book, they're not family. They're not family at all. Okay? In the comics, Eric Killmonger is just this guy, you know, who doesn't like the way that Wakanda is being ran, and decides to gather people together for a revolutionary uprising or whatever. But Michael B. Jordan and the Doctor was set. Chadwick Boseman was Heru. And just like in the myth, in the Asarian myth, these two are brothers. In the Asarian myth, they're uncle and nephew. In the movie, they're cousins. It's the exact same thing. Because N'Jadaka took upon the role of his father, which would be T'Challa's uncle. T'Challa was basically fighting his uncle, because had N'Jadaka kept his father, he wouldn't have became this person that we seen. It would have been T'Challa versus N'Jobu. Do you kind of understand where I'm going with that? But that's what that was with the N'Jadaka and T'Challa characters. They weren't these Marvel characters. That's why this movie can be perceived as a standalone movie. In every aspect, it really is. Nothing really had to be explained, because in the Captain America Civil War movie, the only thing that we took away from that movie concerning Black Panther was his father died. He thought Bucky did it, and he met the CIA agent. All of that is covered in this movie. Okay. Wait a minute. Is that it? Yeah. That's all I'm gonna give you for now. I don't wanna give away too much concerning this movie or whatever. I just wanted to give my perception of how I perceived this movie. I think it was a great movie. A lot of the people who are saying that it was a bad movie, it's a white man's movie, and things like that, they really have no, I'm not gonna go that far with this video, but let me know what you guys think down in the comments. A few of y'all, you know, I've seen your comments under other videos, and I'm pretty sure I know what you're going to say. Those of you who are subscribed to me anyway. Let me know what you think. Like, share, subscribe if you're new to the channel.
And if for two, you've been arguing all your bitch ass, fake ass, black power, RBG wannabe ass life, that they don't ever show enough black positivity on TV. Now, when they finally do, you complaining that it's made by them. So this is see, a motherfucker who is just evil will always find an excuse to express his evilness. First, the argument was white people don't never show black people positive on TV without killing each other. Da da da. Then when they do, and make you the main motherfucking center character and center of attention. Now you want to complain, oh, this movie was made by the white man. Bitch, for the one time white people didn't shit on you, you're still not satisfied. Well, bitch, how about you stop buying Jordans, stop buying weave, shut the fuck up, and make your own fucking movie, motherfucker.
Rex.